days. Today is the 20th day. He has 20 more days left of the Great Lent. In the midst of the Lent, our hope of the church puts the cross before us. The cross before us to remind us of where we're going, to remind us of the remembrance of what was accomplished by our salvation by Christ dying on the cross for us, washing away our sins, destroying the power of death, the power of the devil. It gave us the possibility of newness of life. In the Lenten journey, we've traveled. And now the church gives us a little time of rest under the Holy Cross as it were. We remember the cross, but not only the cross do we remember, but we also remember the resurrection of Christ. The hymn that we just sang. Before thy cross we bow down in worship, O Master, and thy holy resurrection we glorify. The cross and the resurrection always go together. Even in the hymn today of the tone of 7, it's by thy cross thou hast destroyed death. The resurrection hymn today speaks of the cross. It talks about the resurrection, but it speaks of the cross. In the hymn, after we have the resurrection of Christ, we glorify the holy resurrection of Jesus. The better at that cross of Christ and the holy resurrection, we praise and glorify. The cross and resurrection always go together. The victory of the cross is one of gladness and one of joy. When we think of the cross, we remember that Christ suffered on the cross. He suffered for our sake and our behalf. That when he was crucified to the cross, he nailed our sins to the cross with his precious blood and washed away our sins. That is triumph, that is victory, that is joy, that is glorious. What took place historically was humiliation, which was suffering, which was anguish, which was sorrow. It was a dark day, and the sun hid its rays, as it says. But the victory of the cross has been attained already. It is before us all the time, the cross, the sign of victory, the sign of glory. And so the cross is given to us this week, and if we're wise, between now and Friday, every day we'll sing the hymn. O God, say, O Lord, say, thy people bless thy inheritance, the Jephoria of the cross. At the end of our morning and night prayers, we have the prayer this week. Before that cross, we bow down and worship O Master, Lord of resurrection, we praise and glorify. The cross is exposed in the church this whole week, now through Friday. The cross is given to us to remind us that God died for us on the cross. It's a free gift. We don't have to do anything. But it's also not only a gift, it's a task given to us. That if we want to be made worthy of the cross, not to receive the benefits of the cross, that's given to us already. But if we want to identify in love with what Christ has done for us, then there are certain things that our Lord asks us to do as followers. What is he asks in the gospel today? He says, deny yourself, your false self, the image you have of yourself, the image that is of the world and of humanity. Deny this false image, take up your cross, and follow me. To take up the cross is to follow the way of the Lord. The way of the Lord is a difficult way. It's not an easy way. Apostle Paul says that. He says, for me, I die daily. I die daily. He says, I'm crucified with Christ. It's no longer I that live, but it's Christ that lives within me. And so the cross is ours not only for veneration. The cross is given to us for inspiration, is given to us for encouragement, is given for us as support, is given to us as the direction, the North Star that leads us into the kingdom of God. And so this week, we focus upon the cross of Christ, given to us so that we could continue our Lenten journey. The last 3 weeks, we have to ask ourselves, what constituted my Lenten effort? Remember the goals. What were the days? There were 3 goals of the Holy Great Lent. The first goal, again, was to have ourselves spiritually renewed, to awaken ourselves in spiritual lethargy. We do this through repentance, through a change of mind, through a change of attitude. That's called repentance. So renewal for repentance, that was the first goal. The second goal is to establish new priorities according to the teachings of Christ, to reorder our daily lives so that what we're doing, what we're thinking, where we're going, what we're eating, how we spend our time, what our values are, what our desires are, what our expectations are, but then all in conformity. Prioritize according to the teachings of Christ. And the third way was to have a stable and growing life in Christ Jesus in union with Christ. That's the goals, the three goals. The objectives are the objectives of keeping God. The first objective was to have personal and communal prayer. And receive the Holy Sacrament of confession and communion. The second was to engage in fasting as best we can. And the third was to do good deeds or charitable works for the benefit of others. These were the means to the end. But the goal was the most important. And the means, to get to the goal will accomplish nothing. So perhaps we've been lazy this life. Perhaps we haven't really done the same effort every day. Perhaps we haven't gone to the Lenten services, which are just held Monday through Friday. Perhaps we've forgotten to pray for our Lenten prayer partners. Perhaps we've not indulged in increasing our spiritual reading of the scriptures and other spiritual reading. Perhaps we put off Holy Confession and Holy Communion. Perhaps we thought that since we can't keep a full fast, we're not worthy to receive Holy Communion, so we will not have confession and communion. Perhaps these things show weakness on our part. But Lent's not over. There's a whole 20 days yet of the Holy and Great Fast. And so by the power of the cross, by love for our Lord Jesus Christ, we want to be those that increase our labors. If already we're engaged in a good Lent, we have to be careful. The second part of Lent is always more difficult than the first part, because we begin to languish. We begin to fall back into bad habits. You have to remember that the demons are especially active now, especially during Lent, that they tempt us more, that they want us to derail us from any Lenten endeavor. And as we get closer to the Holy Week, the Great and Holy Week, the demons increase their measure of their activity to discourage us, to give us kind of despair, to kind of tell us, well, we didn't do enough. You're too late. That you can't really offer anything now, that we missed the Lent. We have to be mindful of that. We have to be strict in our observance of things. And so, as we venerate the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ, let the cross be for us our joy, our consolation, our support, our inspiration, our guidance, that is by the cross of Christ that everything is accomplished for us. The cross is the anchor that anchors our spiritual life. The cross is the key that opens paradise for us. The cross is the altar on which Jesus Christ shed himself as a sacrifice for our lives, so that by his death we would have eternal life. We don't want this great Lent just to be something on the books. We want this great Lent to be a period of time in which we spiritually grow. We spiritually grow until we come, as the Apostle Paul says, to the perfect stature of the God-man Jesus Christ. That Jesus Christ becomes for us our Alpha and our Omega for all things. I want to remind everybody again that all of us, Orthodox Christians, confession communion is standard for us. It shows that we want to be with Christ, so if we haven't gone to confession communion yet, we should do that in the period of the next 20 days before the Holy and Great Week. During Holy and Great Week, confessions are not scheduled, except college students can, of course, when they come home, they can make arrangements for that. So in the next 20 days, if you haven't been to confession communion, you should do that. Remind you again of the charities of the parish. It's all in the parish notations. And again, this week, this afternoon, 4 p.m., there's Vespers, the evening Vespers at St. Vladimir Church in Trenton. Friday this week is the Eve of the Annunciation. And so there's the first service of the Annunciation Friday evening. And next Saturday, one of the 12 great feast days, the Annunciation to the Holy Theotokos. And the other announcements, the things, please read the